Hi everybody, it's Spring with Soaps and Suds and Such, and what am I doing today? Well, we are wanting to get into mushrooms, growing mushrooms. Personally, I love mushrooms. And plus, they would be beneficial for our soil outside. Do you want to tell me anything?
Well, I thought it would help us with our wood chips, if we're going to be putting wood chips through our gardens. It'll help us break them down faster and produce the humus and stuff and the microorganisms in the soil that we really need for all-around good growing. As we mainly got clay here in the foothills of North Carolina, it ain't the best growing loamy soil, so we're going to do soil amendments with it. And mushrooms will help us break it down a lot quicker, plus provides other microorganisms in the soil that many people don't take into account, but just all around better ecosystem.
And I love eating them. So yeah. These here are that I'm going to be trying to do something with. Now, we've watched videos on YouTube, several different ones, and they tell that you can do it this way. And that you can grow the mycelium. Sorry about that. And then go on with your process. You know, some people were using straw, others were using cardboard, others coffee grounds, wood chips, sawdust, different things. Well, I'm gonna try this and that, but I've got the small button mushrooms, and I'll show you how they say to do them, and you all can just go right along with me, and we'll see if it works. Let me get zoomed in here where you can see what I'm doing. Okay, what they say to do is, like, take a mushroom. I'm getting out of the view here. And got to take out the stem, pull that out. Like so, and I'm just going to use a knife and cut right around here. Most of them I seen just pulled it, but they say that the spores, I've still got some stem in there, I probably need to get out. They say that your spores are in here in this brown part. And they tell you to take your mushroom, which I've got a piece of paper here, white paper. I hope that that's good enough, because that's all the, I've got printer paper, that's it. And we can't afford to buy the spores, so we're trying this. And I wrote on the bottom, small button, if I can get where you can see it, right there. And they say just take it and set it like that, like so. And then take something to cap over it. Well, I've got this is an egg. It is clean. Okay, and also, I guess I should mention, using rubbing alcohol, and I always keep 91% alcohol. If you've seen where I do soap, that's my thing, 91% alcohol. Well, I haven't been able to do soap for a while, so I've got 91% alcohol. So I just wipe down everything with that. But they tell you to do these mushrooms. If I'm getting your view, just pull out the stem like so. They take their fingers, most of them, and pull that back. I figured for me it'd be easier with a knife. So I'm just using the knife to just cut that excess off. And there's what we're looking for. And they say just put it down on your paper like so. And then take something like a cup or whatever you may have, I guess, because that's what I'm doing, and cap it over top of it. Well, I'm going to do the rest of these, and then I'll bring you back and show you what else I'm going to do. Okay, there they are. I did the rest of them, and I just put them all under this container. And I have no clue if this is going to work. Those are baby button, so it may not even have spores. I don't know how that works, but now I'm going to show you. I guess we'll do the big button next. And I have coffee grounds. Okay, I have boiled this straw for a very long time and kept the heat up hot. So there can't be anything, any organisms alive in there, I would not think. Okay, the wood chips, I've just got them started to cook. I'm gonna let them cook for a good while. I also have some pasteboard here. Okay, we're gonna do our baby button mushrooms. And I did use 91% alcohol to clean everything. I've decided to use straw, which I boiled to high heaven. I mean, I boiled that stuff for a very long time. Kept it, you know, very high heat. And I'm also going to use some wood chips, which also were boiled a long time at high heat, and coffee grounds, which will run through the coffee maker. And I've got some cardboard here, was put through boiling water. And we're going to check and see if we got any spore prints on here. So let's just start looking, because I don't know what color these are supposed to be. So I do see a little bit. Nothing like I'd hoped. Oh, that one did pretty good. Looky there. Nothing for that one. Oh, well, a little bit. Very little for most of them. There's pretty good. And I hope this works. People say it does. I have no clue, so I guess we will find out. Because I will do an update video and let you know. Even if it turns green. These little guys didn't do anything, don't look like, hardly. What? There's a good one. That might have been too small. Okay. Don't look like we got a whole lot. Let's see if I can bring you up to see that. See, there's the best, looks like. But I'm going to cut this into pieces, and then I'll bring you back. I've got a clean plate over here, been sterilized, to put the pieces of paper on. Okay, I think I'm going to start with some coffee grounds in the bottom. To see down in there if I got enough everything moved around and placed right. Okay, now we'll put some of our paper, and I really didn't expect to get any spore print off of those little tiny things. I thought they were just too small or something. And I'm gonna put that good one there, right over here. I'll put a tiny one right here, and then I think I'll put some wood chips. Another one. Put a piece up. I think I'll put a piece of cardboard in there. Another one. some straw. Just a little bit, because I forgot to put another piece. I should have put another piece in there, so this one down right here. Put one more straw on top of that, I think. It's kind of fun to do. I mean, I don't know if it'll work, but it's kind of fun. Coffee grounds. And another one up. Some more wood chips. Like so. Okay. And our last ones. I'm gonna put some straw on these. Okay, and I'm gonna tamp that down and get my label ready and my coffee filter, which is drying. I'll bring you back. Okay, I put a label on there. It says small button mushrooms and the date. And like I said, I'll let you know. I'll do a update on this if anything starts growing, or even if it's green, which we hope not. Cross your fingers it's not, because we really want to grow mushrooms. And you want to watch more of our videos or see the follow-up on these, click subscribe. Hit that little bell that'll notify you to let you know every time I upload. Remember to check out Dr. Paul Stamets and channel. I'll put the link in the description box, because I tell you, it's unreal. He's really become a mentor to us. And thanks for watching. I will do a follow-up on, well, you see them back there. Got several in there. Video on them. And happy mushrooming, soaping, whatever you may be doing. And thanks again for watching.